Hello, welcome to Bite Size Med. This video is on the cardiac cycle, and in part 4, we're going to look at the ventricular and aortic pressure changes that happen during one cycle. The cardiac cycle includes a bunch of different things that happen in the heart between beats. Each cycle can be divided into phases, and during each phase, there are changes in volume and in pressure. I went over some of the volume changes in part 2. The pressure changes, they happen in the atria, the ventricles, and the big vessels, that's the pulmonary trunk and the aorta. We went over atrial pressure changes in part 3. So what's left? The ventricles and the big vessels that emerge from them. The pressure changes are similar on both sides of the heart, apart from one key difference. The systolic pressures in the left ventricle and the aorta are much higher than the right ventricle and the pulmonary trunk. So if you look at a curve for the pressure changes, they would look flatter on the right than the left. For convenience, we usually look at the left ventricle and the aortic pressure changes. Between the left atrium and the left ventricle is the mitral valve, which is an atrioventricular valve. The right side has the tricuspid valve. Between the left ventricle and the aorta is the aortic valve, which is a semilunar valve. The right side has the pulmonary valve. And this is my schematic heart that I'm going to be using to explain what happens. The cardiac cycle has a systolic and a diastolic phase, and these phases happen in both the atria and the ventricles. Systole is when they contract and diastole is when they relax, and they overlap between the chambers. If we start with atrial systole, that lasts a short duration, and the rest of the cycle is an atrial diastole. Now, ventricular systole starts after atrial systole, and is longer, overlapping with atrial diastole. It's followed by ventricular diastole, which completes the cycle. And this cycle is going to repeat, so you can see the overlap. We'll bring back the schematic heart, and we're going to be looking at the ventricular pressure changes. During atrial systole, and ventricular diastole, atrial systole repeats starting the next cycle. What happens during atrial systole? The atria contract, pushing the last bit of blood into the ventricles. That will cause the ventricular pressure to rise a little as blood gets pushed in. Then the atrioventricular valves close. With all valves closed, the ventricles contract. Blood doesn't leave the chamber, so the volume does not change. That's isovolumetric contraction. The volume doesn't change, but the muscle is contracting, causing the pressure to rise. The pressure rises during isovolumetric contraction. We're focusing on the left side of the heart, so when the pressure in the left ventricle goes higher than the aortic pressure, the aortic valve opens. Blood gets ejected out during the ejection phase, first rapid ejection and then slow ejection. During this ejection phase, the pressure in the ventricle would reach a peak, and then it starts to fall. The aortic valve closes, and now again with all valves closed, the ventricle relaxes in isovolumetric relaxation. The pressure drops. Once the ventricular pressure goes below the atrial pressure, so it goes quite low, that's when the atrioventricular valve, that's the mitral valve on the left, opens. Now the ventricles start filling. The pressure in the ventricles stay low because they are relaxing and they're compliant until the atria contract, and that causes a slight rise in pressure again during atrial systole. So we're back at the start and the cycle will repeat. For the left ventricle, these arrows will form a curve that looks something like this. Clearly, the left ventricular pressure curve is much taller than the left atrial pressure curve, because the pressure is much higher in the ventricles during systole. For the left heart, the mitral valve closes at the start of isovolumetric contraction, and at the end of this phase, the aortic valve opens. The aortic valve closes at the start of isovolumetric relaxation, which then ends with the opening of the mitral valve. There is a slight rise in pressure during atrial systole. Then the pressure rises a lot more during isovolumetric contraction. The pressure peaks during the ejection phase and it starts falling. The pressure comes down quite low during isovolumetric relaxation. Once it goes lower than the atrial pressure, the ventricles fill because the valves open, but the pressure stays low. With a slight rise again during atrial systole, and the cycle repeats. That's how the left ventricle's pressure changes during one cardiac cycle. The left ventricle pumped blood out into the aorta, and the aortic pressure curve follows the left ventricular curve more or less, but there are some obvious differences. During atrial systole, the pressure in the aorta is coming down because this is happening during ventricular diastole, which overlaps with atrial systole. Now, this will make sense when we finish the cycle. During isovolumetric contraction, the ventricular pressure rises quite a bit. And by the end of this phase, it overtakes the aortic pressure. So that opens the aortic valve. The curves cross. Blood gets pumped into the aorta, causing the pressure to peak during ventricular systole. That is the systolic pressure. If we assume the aortic pressure is 120 over 80 millimeters of mercury, then the pressure would peak at 120 millimeters of mercury. That is the systolic pressure. Though the aortic pressure has now crossed the left ventricular pressure, the valve doesn't close just yet because of the inertia of blood flow. The pressure comes down and the aortic valve closes. But after that, there's this little notch, and this is called the dicrotic notch or the incisura. This little blip is supposed to be because at the time of aortic valve closure, some amount of blood flows back towards the ventricle. But then the blood runs off into the arterial system and the pressure drops, so the curve goes down. But not as far down as the ventricles. That's because of the elastic recoil in the walls of the aorta, which maintains the diastolic pressure higher than the ventricle. That's the 80 of the 120-80. So the curve stays up here. That's the aortic pressure. Now what's next in the journey for this blood? The arteries. So the pressure gets transmitted through the arterial system. And that's all about ventricular and aortic pressure during the cardiac cycle. I hope this video was helpful. If it was, you can give it a like and subscribe to my channel. Thanks for watching. I'll see you in the next one.